The world's oceans play a crucial role in life on Earth, especially in relation to its influence on weather. The seas heat and cool, they humidify and dry the air, and they can control wind speed and direction. To help scientists continue studies from the vantage point of 830 miles above the Earth, NASA will launch the Jason-3 satellite early in 2016 from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. Since 1992, this will be the fourth in a series of spacecraft providing scientists with essential information about global and regional changes in the seas.
These satellites measure the height of the ocean from space, and that's important for oceanographers because it tells us about ocean currents, about tides.
The more that is understood about the level of the world's oceans, the better experts can predict the changing dynamics of weather and climate of Earth. Data from Jason-3 will provide information about oceans that forecasters need to better predict severe weather and devastating hurricanes before they arrive on shore. The satellite also will help scientists track rising global sea levels. Since the data acquired by Jason-3 will have global applications, it's appropriate that the mission is a joint international endeavor.
And the actual spacecraft is built in France by Thales Alenia under contract to CNES. And the spacecraft was delivered to the launch site back on June 18, 2015.
CNES is the French space agency, the National Center for Space Studies. NASA will launch the satellite for NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, and EUMETSAT, the European Organization for the Exploitation of Meteorological Satellites.
Jason-3 will launch from Vandenberg Air Force Base on the Central California coast into a polar orbit. That's important for the mission because Jason-3 is an ocean topography mapping mission. And going into a polar orbit around the Earth, with the Earth rotating underneath the spacecraft, enables Jason-3 to see as much ocean on a recurring basis as possible.
The Jason-3 satellite will be boosted to orbit by a SpaceX launch vehicle.
The Jason-3 spacecraft will launch on the Falcon 9 rocket. Falcon 9 is manufactured by SpaceX in the Los Angeles area. The NASA Launch Services team has been working very methodically over the past few years, and certainly during this intense period of a launch campaign at Vandenberg Air Force Base over the past several months, in making sure that we are ready to fly Jason-3 successfully.
Once Jason-3 reaches orbit, there is still work to be done to prepare for its job of measuring the ocean surfaces.
So the first thing that happens after the spacecraft separates from the launch vehicle is that the solar panels will be deployed, and the spacecraft will be pointed in the right attitude. Once the spacecraft is stable, charged, and communicating with the ground stations, then you can send commands to the spacecraft to initiate the various checkouts of the subsystems on the spacecraft.
NASA's Launch Services Program is very excited about the Jason-3 launch campaign. It's exciting science. We're excited to work with SpaceX. The joint commercial and government team has put in many hours for this countdown, and we are looking forward to mission success.